Hey, what's up guys, it's Tekosaur. So if you got a Samsung Galaxy Book 4 Ultra and actually checked its SSD temps, you might have been pretty shocked by how hot it gets, to a degree that even the sensor itself warns it's overheating, like it literally flags the drive as too hot. Bruh. This could potentially degrade its lifespan by a significant amount. Like you see, just by running Crystal Disk benchmark one time, temps shot up to 88 degrees Celsius. The pre-installed SSD drive that comes with the Galaxy Book 4 Ultra is a Gen 4 drive. And as you probably know, Gen 4 SSDs tend to run pretty hot without sufficient cooling. So in this video, I'm gonna step in to save this drive's life by applying a heatsink with thermal pads to see how much cooler it can run, and then compare the temperatures before and after. So with that said, let's get to it to see the exact kind of cooling setup I'll be applying. And also here I have this SSD drive by Fanxiang and it's PCIe 4. I'm gonna also put it alongside the pre-installed SSD drive in order to have two drives and in order to check out the difference in temperature. So it's 1 terabyte. A good thing about this SSD is that it comes with a heatsink, but I don't believe it's gonna fit well because, like you can see, it's pretty huge. I don't believe you could close the back cover with it installed. So for that, I got actually different types of heat sinks that I'm going to apply instead. They come in 0.8, 1 millimeter and 2 millimeters actually. And included, we'll also find some thermal pads. So this one is 1 millimeter. And I also got this slim heat sink that I believe many of you are familiar with, that you can apply to literally every device. So I'll test it also. I'll try first to see if the 2 millimeter one will fit in just fine. And if it didn't work, I'll just go back in smaller sizes. So first we need to remove those 4 paddings to unhide the screw holes, like the screw locations. So I'll start off by lifting them off, like using a pry tool in order to not damage them. Like you can always reinstall them back again, of course. Once you do it, you will just find the screw holes with 4 screws in total on the back. And now once that I removed all the screws, I can lift it off without using like a pry tool or anything. You can do it like just gently, try to lift it off using your fingers. But if you feel it like it's too tight, you can always use a pry tool to make it easier. But in my case, like, it was possible to do it without any kind of a tool. And here you will see the notebook. It actually looks nice from the inside. Like, I like the fact that it has this vapor chamber area. It has dual fans. So anyway, here is the pre-installed SSD. You can see that there are 2 SSD slots. One which come pre-installed with an SSD and there is an empty one. So you can use on this Galaxy Book 4 Ultra 2 SSD drives actually. So first I'll start to put on a thermal pad on the pre-installed SSD one. So you can see that this SSD drive has single-sided memory chips. So on the back side it has nothing at all. You can see it's just a board. So that's why I'm not going to put any thermal pads on this area. And instead put everything on the front side. So here you can see that we have actually 4 memory chips. So I'm going to put on all of them. They are 1 millimeter thickness. Hopefully they are gonna do great temp reduction. Here I got the 2 millimeter one. So I'll just put it on top of them. And now using the included rubber band, I'll just put them all together so there isn't any kind of screw or anything. You can see the heatsink is making great contact with the thermal pads and the thermal pads are making great contact with the memory chips. So we are good. You see the fan next to it, how they have the same height. I will say that hopefully it's gonna work with the 2 millimeter heatsink with the thermal pads of 1 millimeter, so in total 3 millimeter add thickness on top of the SSD. Now here is the second SSD. We have the Fanxiang one. So you can see that this one has different structure actually. Like you see, it's double-sided. It has two memory chips on one side and two on the other one. I'm gonna put thermal pads on those four memory chips. And you see with its included heatsink, it's gonna be impossible to put it in and close the back covers. That's why I'm gonna skip the included heatsink altogether and instead use one of those heatsinks that I got from AliExpress. I settled actually with the slim one, like just to do some variation in case you found it more accessible for you. I wanted to test it out to see how much temperatures it will at least get. So the thermal pads I'm gonna use on this one are 0.8 actually. This is the maximum size that it comes with actually in this pack. So I'll use the ones that they provided. And now we are good. I'll just put on the heatsink. You will find the screw inside the notebook remounted. You just need to unscrew it. And now the moment of truth has come. We're gonna try to close the back cover to see if it's actually going to close just fine without any breakage or issues. You just need to press it little by little. But overall, you can see that we managed to close it just fine and it's not really suffering from anything. So it seems that after all, there was enough clearance to put on heatsink on the original SSD, as well as put another SSD drive and put on some heatsink. I'm really excited to see the kind of temperature drop we're gonna see. Now, when you install the second drive, you will not find it in the file explorer, like you will not find it anywhere inside your PC. That's just fine because you just need to initiate it. So if you don't see it, that's just fine. Just go to create and format hard disk partitions. You will see, you will get this pop-up saying that you must initiate a disk before logical disk manager can access it. So just select the disks that you want, press OK, keep everything on default, and you will find it here, unallocated. Just press right-click, then new symbol volume. Assign a letter to it, in this case D. You can also name it the way that you would like. In this case, name it, for example, secondary drive. Give file system to NTFS, and allocation unit size to default. And also toggle on the preform a quick disk format, and that's it. Give it a few seconds and you will find it permanently accessible. Thanks to the cooling we add with the heatsink, our SSD temps dropped by exactly 18 degrees, running the same crystal disk benchmark. That's actually pretty great and honestly really useful, easy and low cost mode, because it will greatly improve your SSD lifespan as well as reducing nearby component temps as well. Running the same benchmark again on the Fanxiang SSD along with the 0.8 mm thermal pad and that slim heatsink, here are the performance scores we got. Looking at the temps, the max SSD temperature we got on the Fanxiang drive was around 72 degrees Celsius, and that's actually pretty good considering how fast the drive is and how slim the heatsink is. I'm sure without it, temps would have easily hit 90 degrees. So anyway guys, I wanted to make this video mainly for Galaxy Book 4 Ultra users who want to improve their SSD temps. Of course, this kind of upgrade could work on almost any notebook, though cooling results can vary depending on drive speed and heatsink size, so you will need to measure the possible clearance on yours. Still, I wanted to show the positive effect this small change can have. So I hope you found this video useful, and if you did, drop a like and subscribe to the channel. I've got a lot of cool stuff coming up, so stay tuned. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.